So today what we'll learn is, like, first of all, let's start with appending, okay, tables, and then afterwards we'll go with some grouping, okay, of tables for whatever the data that we do have, and then afterwards we'll check with the fuzzy match also for in this session. Yeah, okay. So let me show you the details of that particular table. This is my online sales table, okay. So you can see this, and this is my store sales table. Okay, you have like different columns. Okay, then this is my wholesale sales. You can see the channel name, date, customer ID, units. Okay, and again here, yes. Channel name, date, customer. The column names are same. Okay, there is no such kind of things. And then here I do have like one and the refer kind of a column, extra column. But all the other columns are same. Columns maybe here are there, but still column names are same and the data types are same. So whenever the column names and the data types are same, it may have like some other extra columns, but that is not a problem. The existing columns, what are there, need to have like same data type and then same column name. That is what mandatory to add to a couple of, maybe two or three or a couple of tables. It's like, okay, earlier also we done, okay, merging. There's also some kind of addition adding only, but here appending it means, okay, so what we are doing is we are not comparing with any of the column. No column or common values needed over here. Only thing is the structure schema of the table need to be equal. Mm-hmm. And then here we are adding the rows. Like all the rows from this table will be added to the rows to this table. So wherever the column exists, but that if there is no column exists, then obviously we'll get that, we'll nulls in that places. Here we are adding, okay, rows to the upper rows. We are adding the lower table rows, combining two tables into one table. That's it.
Okay.
So this is what exactly we need to understand this one. So I do have an order table or sales table, online sales table. So I'll go to append. Append means like, okay, we call it as union right now. Mm-hmm. Okay, and then like come here, append queries. Okay. So this is like, obviously, as we know earlier in the merge queries, append queries means we will have the other table rows also over here in the same table. So this table will be disturbed and then it will be converted into another table. So I don't want to do that. I want to keep it, this table is the safe. So obviously I'll go with create a new table. So append queries, new table. So another pop-up window will be shown. And then if you want to add two tables, then obviously you'll select this. If you want to add more than two tables, you'll select this.
Okay.
So I want to add right now two tables. So obviously online sales. And second step one is like full sales. So you want to add these two in a new table. So I got a new table. Here you can see online sales and the whole.
Wholesale, yeah.
Yeah. At the same time, I do have like, okay, three other table also, store sales. I can even combine with this table also, but I want to make it from fresh. Okay, so append query and then append queries, and I'll show you how it will be like if you add these three tables. So three tables, online sales obviously have been taken, and then store sales I'll add this one, then like wholesale sales I'll add over here. So I got three tables, then click OK. I have second append table, and here you can see like, okay, all the rows has been cleaned. But here,
yes,
in the table, we do have some other column for this particular store sales. So that row will come in, then for the remaining rows, for the remaining table, we'll get spent. Simple thing. And then coming to like, so there is no much concept over here in this thing. Okay, we do have this kind of things only. Yeah, and then like coming here, we've been done with this union kind of thing, append, which is called as append. And then afterwards, we'll go with like fuzzy match. Fuzzy match, nothing but, okay, I do have two tables. One is like this one and You can see the table over here. It is like fruit. Okay, apple, pineapple, watermelon, and banana. I do have four fruits. And when the people do some survey, okay, for the, like, they've been written like this. While they do the survey, like, what is the fruit that all the students needed, then some student, okay, just written like this, maybe spelling mistakes or whatever it may be, they're written in this format. So we want to, like, join with these two things. So when we have, like, data, similar data, then only we can join, obviously. But I do have, like, some of them are similar data, some of them are non-similar data, then obviously we can't do direct match. So what we can do, we can go with fuzzy match. Fuzzy match means obviously what it does is like, okay, it will check whether this is equal to that or not. Okay. So there will give some values, other values also according to that, it will select. I'll tell you like how it selects and then how it does. Okay. So first of all, what I'll do, I'll go with fruits and then I'll make joins. This is join kind of thing. So the joins will find that one. So it's not a union, okay. The second one is like okay, first survey. I have two tables. I can make it, but if I do like I have only two matches from here, which are like have exactly the same values. I do have matches, but I just need to have a lot of matches. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll ask it to use fuzzy match. When you use fuzzy match, obviously four values has been used. Okay, and then fuzzy match options can have like a lot of things. Over here, these two things. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And then if you ignore case, obviously there will be some change. If there are a lot of values, then we can see a lot of changes. Okay, if you don't have like that thing, then obviously if you don't use fuzzy match, only two rows will be like have a relationship. Okay. So okay. I want to like make it. Use fuzzy match, then obviously I have like 8 of 9 has been matched. Okay, if I ignore case sensitive, then only 6 of 9 has been matched. If I match text parts, then obviously 6 of 9 has been matched. So yes. Ignoring case means okay, if it is lower case and upper case, also ignore that kind of things. We're trying to tell it in that way. So according to that, it will do, and then like even we can give it like from 0.1 to 1, obviously according to that. Okay. This is like, okay, threshold, we'll call it as threshold. We will use only big kind of data only. So I'll just show you how it looks. Which table, go ahead and then like, questions. You can see all the things are matched, only APLS did not match over here. So all the things have been matched.
But even though here spelling mistakes like B-A-N-N-A and here B-A-N-N, still it's matching.
It will take. That is what fuzzy match called. That is why even APPLG also it recognized as an apple. Mm. But APLS, it did not recognize it because either S is there, so it is unable to match the records. So all the other things, here I do have space. I don't have any space, but still it matched. And then here, one is like capital letter M, W, and then here it is like small letters. It is trying to do that. So obviously we'll have like a lot of scenarios that fuzzy match will check and then like it will do that thing.
Okay.
Okay, so in that scenario, we'll use that. Then while once you give the fuzzy match to these columns, okay, these things, and then if it is like a very big data, you need to at least check with the data, like whether they are coming right or not. Somewhere, some point of time, we may get some errors over here.
Okay.
So we need to check the data because if I there is banana and then like there is something like banana, I don't know, like maybe names, customer names or something else, maybe similar to that. And then in that case, then obviously we need to like reduce the threshold. Okay. Threshold will be from 0.1 to 1. Okay, so when we reduce the threshold and then when we fix it, then obviously we'll get that one.
Okay.
That is the second thing that we need to like work on. And again, I'll just get the data. Okay. Source, Excel file, and then grouping, transpose, and reverse. fill example and then like okay, this is a small example. That's going to be a big thing. Reverse and transpose also will check it out. All the things. So got the data. Okay, and then like yep. Okay, and then like. Go with this fill. Fill is nothing but okay. I don't know whether we have been tried this one, but fill is there. This transform we have like kind of thing. There is this fill. A fill. But if you expand it, then obviously you'll get that name. So fill is nothing but okay. When we have like nulls or blanks, okay, and then obviously we do have some value, and we want to fill with that value until we get a new value, new existing. New value. So until we get the new value, we want to fill all these values. Then obviously we'll go here, and then if we want to fill down, obviously we'll get this fill down. So until it get like 15 2020, it will be like 11 2020. Once it is like 15 2020, after that, all the other blanks will be done with this thing.
Yes.
Okay. So this is what one thing, and then like second thing is like if you want to fill from bottom to upper side, here you can see. I do have something over here, and then I do have something over here, and then I do have blanks on the upper side. So obviously, we want to do that. Okay, so select that one and then fill upwards. The value will be filled upwards. The lower will be replaced in the upper side.
Okay.
You fill one, and then like reverse. Reverse is very simple. If you want to like reverse the values in this particular column, obviously you click that, and then is this reverse rows? Is this reverse rows? You can see earlier it was like 1 2 3 5 4 7 6, and here it is like from the bottom 1 2 3 5 4 7 6. Whatever the value that you give, it will be reversed. Even you can reverse this one.
Okay,
that bottom will be like upper, or will be bottom, and then the middle one is also converted in that same way. It's the reverse. This is transpose. Transpose is nothing but simply 2D kind of data in this one conversion. I'll show you what exactly it is. Where is transpose? Rows will convert into columns, the columns will be converted to rows. Earlier this was into this type, and here it was converted into like this type. Yeah, I do have like two rows, participants and funds. These rows will be converted into columns. Participants and funds. Earlier I used to have like three columns, which are like event one, event two, event three. Here it was like event one, event two, event three. So this is how we do. Okay. And then coming to fill transpose, fill examples, and then group by. So we'll go with this group by. Interesting concept. Okay. So here I do have like 2020 sales, okay, in three countries. I sold like okay shirts and shorts. I sold it in three ways. One is online, one is a reseller mode, and one is like okay. I made it in two modes. One is online, one is like all reseller mode means in offline.
Okay.
Online mode and reseller mode. And these are the units that are sold out. These many units were sold out. Okay, in 2020, USA, shirts in online mode. They sold. I sold it in. I sold only 5,000 units. Then coming to like USA in shorts, and then I've been sold on in online. I've been sold 2,500. So in that way, I do have like a table. But what I need to do is like, okay, I just need to have tables such a way that all the USA kind of things need to be like one place. In I just need to get that one. Like I just need to grouping. So we'll practice a lot of the scenarios over here, one by one by one, and then like you can understand what we are trying to do. Excuse me. Country, and then like I want to make some grouping. So what I want to do is like add columns, okay, transpose, and then we'll have like group by, where is group by? And here we'll have like group by. Yep. The home will have like group by. Okay, if you ask for the group by, what column like you want to do that? Okay, so obviously I want like go with country. Then what is the column name that you want to get? Okay, so new column will be like, okay, something like products. So let's make it like same count. Count rows or else not like that. Okay, some I want to make add of this unit. So for USA, I want to like get total units sold. USA, and then like as per the country, for each and every country. You can see for USA, like total sales are this one, and then Panama total sales are this one, and Canada like, total sales are this one.
Yes.
Okay. 6651. Okay. Mm-hmm. So, and this is another thing. And then what is that? Okay, I just don't want to do that. So I'll come back again, and then I want to do grouping again. So right now I want to like group by country again, but I want to like count it. Okay, so count rows, and then like how many like sales were done. Okay, in USA, how many different types of sales were done. In USA, four types of sales were done. One is like, okay, shorts online, and then shorts offline, and then shirts online, and then shirts offline.
Yes.
So in that way it was done. Okay, so if you don't understand, I'll show you. So yes, yeah, we do have four kinds of sales. Okay, in Panama, yes, we do have four kinds of sales.
Yes.
And then in Canada, we do have three kinds of sales. Okay.
Yes.
And combination of these things. So we made it count like that. This is another kind of thing. And then right now I want to like make it another change. Small change. Here I don't want to go with count rows. I want to get the maximum this particular value. Okay, then I want to make it like max. This is the column name, whatever you want, you can like write it some also, not an issue. This is the maximum sale that was done, the maximum units that was sold. Okay, so you can see that in shirts online, I do have 5, and then shorts online, I do have like 2,500, and then shirts reseller 3,000. So, comparatively, total USA. In this thing, I do have 5,000 is the highest one.
Mm-hmm.
In Panama, what is the highest one?
3,500.
And then Canada, 3,256. This is what we are getting here. So as per our requirement, we can choose whatever we want. Okay, so I'll just show you one other thing. Okay, so here I guess I just asked for this thing, and then you can ask for call average or whatever it might be, or whatever, all the rows, if you want to show all the rows. Table format. Then like it will show us all the things again. But I don't want to do that. I'll get the same table, but I don't want to do that. So obviously what I'll do is we'll go with sum or something else. So right now you have been done with one column. You've been done with one column. Right now I want to go and use the advanced options. Then I want to go with some other advanced things. So here, earlier I was used to group by only one column. Right now I want to group by with the second column, like which is products. Again, some of the units. You can see they're like So you can see right now in USA, shorts, they don't have the reseller or else online sales. So in USA, total shorts for sale, like whether it might be a reseller or online, they made it like 8,000. And then if it is like USA shorts, okay, they made it like 7,000. For Panama, for shorts, it is like 5,163. For Panama shorts, it's like 60,446. In Canada, shorts like 5,401. In Canada shorts is like 1,250.
Yes.
So this way here we made it two columns, group by, and then based upon that we get the answers. Same thing here, we can do a lot of things. I don't want to like do that. I want to average or particular units. So I got the average. Maybe small difference. This one, it was earlier, maybe. Then we can come again and then like do some. I don't want to make my product. I want to make a channel. And then I want to make, find out the max here and then units. Something like whatever, maybe some. So I got the sum for online, total online, USA, I do have 75. For online, USA reseller, I do have 75. So you can check it out here, USA online, 75, and then USA offline also 75, same thing. So doing grouping according to the requirement is your own skills. Like, I just need this kind of things, so what we can do, then obviously what you want. This kind of things, for example, I'll give you a real-time scenario. A very important real-time scenario. These kind of scenarios you will get in real-time very frequently.
Okay.
So to achieve that real-time scenario, we do have to do a couple of things that we can do. We can do it in DAX also using summarized things, and then you can do it in Power Query also. Okay, so Power Query, what we'll do and what the scenario is, okay? So let us suppose that I do have subscriptions are active users. Okay, so the people who are having, I just need to find first of all, let me tell you a complete scenario, and then I will split it into two, and then obviously we can just check it out over here. I do have customers in Netflix. Okay, so they are going to recharge every month. But okay, I want to check whether they are just at least like recharging for, okay, people recharge okay when they're free, and then they don't recharge when they're not, when they're busy. This thing happens. A lot of times, okay, we don't use to go with the yearly pack. We want to go with only monthly pack, because whenever we need, whenever we have like good pictures, obviously we'll recharge that. And then we don't have any new releases in that month, obviously we don't recharge that. In this way, people like do that. So they want to check with who are active customers. So we ask them, what does active customers means in your sense? Then he told like, okay, the people who are at least done 4 or 5 recharges a year, then those are active customers.
Mm-hmm.
It's not necessary to recharge a whole year. At least 5 months, if they recharge, then obviously, okay, I just need to make it like active customer. So what we can do is we need to, I do have a lot of years, 10 years data. I do have a lot of customers names will be repeated. If you recharge, okay, your name will come, and then you do have a recharge ID obviously every day. So in a like year, you might have like 5 times, 6 times, and some people will have 12 times also recharges. So whenever you have like, okay, I don't have count of this one. I do have year, date, okay. I do have date, I do have customer names, and then I do have like customer, okay, reference ID. Reference ID means, okay, purchase ID. So whenever they make purchase a recharge or recharge call, whatever it might be, obviously, whenever they do a recharge, there will be like, okay, purchase ID. Recharge ID or transaction ID, whatever it might be. So based upon these three values, you need to find out how many people are active, or else you want to get the details of the people like who are active. So in this scenario, we can't do directly answer over here in the Power Query. We need to achieve that up to like, okay, maximum part over here, and after that we can count that.
Okay.
What we need to do is we need to like calculate individual like customer who are okay. Let us suppose that I do have like okay 10,000 customers altogether. I want to count for each and every customer how many times does they recharge, and that too for each and every year. It's not like okay I may recharge okay two times the last year. This year, then obviously I'll become an active customer because they want to give some discount for active customers who are okay going to recharge for 5 months at least, and they'll give that okay, if you recharge for okay 10 months we'll give you 12 months this whole year package. So just to improve their business.
Okay.
So in that case they want to like check it out how many people are having okay are active, just like how many people are recharging at least 5 times a year. They don't want to give this offer message to all the people because the people who are recharged 1 or 2 months, okay, they don't obviously don't come to recharge for a whole year. The people who are at least 5 to 6 months, then obviously if they give some offer, they'll go with the yearly fees. This is general logic. So in that they want to plan. So in that scenario, what we can do is like, okay, we need to group. Like first of all, you need to understand this. So did you understand the scenario?
Yes.
So in that scenario, first what we can do is we can't directly count that one.
Mm.
Or else we can even count also. Like we can do that, okay, count of this one, but we can't make it active or inactive. So we can just show them the count, how many times this active ID has been counted. Okay, in that case, what we'll do is I'll show you all here so that you can have an idea of this. Okay. So here let's see this. Okay. So what we'll do is let us say this country is a year. Okay. Country is a year column. It's not like okay, okay. Whole date column. I do have date column, but what we'll do is you just get the year from out of that. You know how to do that using date.
Yes.
So you'll get the date column from out of that from out of the date you'll get year. So years will be like okay, same for every year. Like for 2002, it is like 2000. The whole 2021, you'll have 2021 only. So now obviously, so what we'll do is we'll group by year. This one is like year. The second one is like customer name. And in the logic, what you'll write is you'll write okay, like count of okay, recharges column. Then here you'll ask for count rows. Then like here, count is 10 rows or like all rows or whatever it may be. Like you'll do that one. And then obviously you'll get that one. Okay. You'll get that answer. Okay, so how many people, like how many times the things come on cases. You'll have like, okay, so here for online, okay, we don't have like the same way we'll get a click that if this online is a one guy and then resell is another guy, let us suppose that. And then this online is another guy. It is not like this online one is not one. While we group only, we'll get okay, things like unique one. Only. Here we made it by two things. So obviously we got it like that. So for this year. Okay, so for 2020, we'll get all the 2020s and then all the people. And then like here. And then again, like all the 2021 people, all the customers, and then how many types. So that based upon years, okay, you can select like, okay, if you want like for this year, then obviously you can select for this year, 2020, that you can write it in measure. Obviously you'll get over here, like how many recharges they have been done in each year. Year-wise, customer-wise recharges, count of recharges. So obviously we'll get, okay, so once we go into DAX, we'll write some filter and then count it, like count of this value. That's what they, how they will show like, okay, account of these things where whatever it might be, the count of recharges is greater than or equal to 5, then count of this one. So obviously we'll get the unique number of people, count of people who are active in this particular year. To achieve that kind of logics, what you can do is you can use group by hour here sometimes. And in sometimes what you do is like, okay, you need to go and then in DAX, you can write it using summaries or summaries columns. Then again, this grouping is also already used in some other cases. So let us suppose I do have 2 million rows. Okay. I do have 2 million rows. And okay. And what I need is like, I don't need daily sales. Whole report, in my whole report, I don't need any daily sales. I do have 10 years of data. So if I want to like reduce the burden of that particular Power BI report, then what I can do is, as I don't have daily content in, like I don't need any daily regarding daily report in my reports. I don't need any daily statistics in my reports. I need only monthly and yearly statistics. So obviously what we'll do is, we will come over here and we'll segregate, like we'll group it for months. So obviously every value will be like added, like aggregated to that particular month, as we don't need daily data. So once we done this aggregation for monthly wise, then obviously a lot of rows burden will be decreased, and then we have like only very few, like okay, like in like 1 lakh, 2 lakh, that kind of, from millions to lakhs, it will directly convert into that. Okay, so this is a trick that we'll use for performance tuning. We'll do some aggregations of the data, so that whenever we don't need the lower level of data, then obviously we'll do some aggregations, and then we'll show that. So then I can have other real-time example for grouping.
Okay.
So just practice this one. Then if you don't be able to do that one, I'll just give you that scenario data. Just simply you can write some data, like you can say, take some random data, and then you can take some names, randomly, 5 names, then repeatedly you just paste things. Then afterwards you give some like ID, just like random ID. Things like, okay. So for after 100 or 200 rows, you can give that, and afterwards you can practice upon that. So obviously you'll get that things. Even if you need something else, I'll try to give those kind of data also. You can work upon. But at this instance, I just need to prepare that. So you can even type the data from your side. I hope you, if you are good at typing, you can make it so fast.
Okay.
If you are not good at it, maybe it takes some time, but still, it works.
Yeah.
This is the way you can practice. Once again, wherever I tell you some scenario, then obviously. Then did you practice that one? While you are getting like a key, some kind of thing, whenever your sum is texting, then obviously it will show that. So that you need to check with the data whether what type of is that. Text we can't submit, we need to only concatenate. Okay, yesterday scenario.
Yes.
That's it for today, and then we will learn tomorrow something, new concepts, but okay, this thing, grouping is so important. Try to practice this and then like try to get, okay, so what we have been learned, okay, real-time scenarios also, you can try to do that. Whenever you have like take a lot of data, then no need to like write 10 names or something else and repeat randomly these names, and then like you can give some values, some 10 to 20 values, and repeat them randomly. So you'll have a lot of big data. Even we do have like some data, like in our whichever table I have been given, like superstore data.
Yes.
And then come over here and then delete all the rows which you don't need. Take only date, then take some customer names, then take some sales.
Okay.
Or else take the ID.
Okay.
Take the customer ID, order ID, whatever it might be. Based upon that, you can do the same examples what we've been done. So that you'll have like more interesting things, and at the same time, you'll understand what exactly. From that date column, you create month and then year also. So that you can say, if needed, you can segregate to monthly. If needed, you can segregate to yearly.
Okay.
It's not like, okay, I do have monthly date column. What I'll do with that means you need to obviously convert from that date to months and then columns, years, and then you can work it out however you want.
Okay.
Okay, that's it. Fine. And then let me stop the recording.